Welcome to NAOS Studio. I am Dr. Amrit J. Kumar. I am working as Associate Professor in the Department of Education of Central University of Kerala. Today we will be discussing about evolution and conception of social sciences. Social science is a branch of knowledge which studies about human society and human relationships. Also, it looks into social behavior of human being. Social sciences have great relevance for the modern day society and hence from an important component or part of modern day of education and our curriculum system. We cannot belittle the importance of social sciences in the flood of science subjects and the preferences for science subjects. Social science do demand a very significant position among the curricular subjects in our modern system. Let us look into the evolution of social sciences. The social sciences, the subject or the field of study, we call it as social sciences, evolved during the 18th century as a formal field of study. And it has become a part of university higher education curriculum very soon. Not in India, but in Europe and other places. Social studies, which draws its contents from different social sciences, evolved only during 20th century. So this is a major difference between social science and social studies. Social science has found its origin in 18th century, while social studies, which draws its content from different social science, evolved only during the 20th century. And they found their position in school or junior school curriculum very soon. The evolution of growth of social sciences are the byproduct of actually modernization, industrialization, renaissance, urbanization, and growth of science and many other related developments. As we all know, modernization is an important factor which has resulted in the evolution of social sciences. The new form of thinking, the new way of thinking, which was initiated by people like Galileo Galilei, Isaac Newton, and all these have great influence in the evolution of modern social sciences. And another important one is industrialization. The origin of industrialization in Britain due to the Industrial Revolution has a great influence on our social system and in human behavior and in our social life. This has resulted in a great influence upon the formation of social sciences. And of course, Renaissance, which was originated in Italy, has a great important influence on the social sciences. Urbanization is an important thing. Earlier, our people were living in rural villages and hinterlands where the social relations have followed a particular pattern. When industrialization and urbanization came in, the relationship between human being has got changed. Our social life has got changed. Our living system has got changed. All these have great influence on social science system. The growth of science and many other related developments also have great influence upon the social science as a subject. Our exploration into social sciences, knowledge generation into social sciences are all greatly influenced by the science and scientific methods. There were many changes in human lives and living which were hardly seen before during the 18th century and afterwards. The whole world took a radical turn since the 18th century. Renaissance in Italy and other European countries were a significant part of this radical turn. And also French Revolution, which took out in 1789. Then Industrial Revolution started in England as a result of the invention of the steam engine by James Watt in 1767. And then American War of Independence in 1776. Development of new forms of capitalism in developed nations was another important change. Immense development in natural sciences is another important change. All these changes has greatly and immensely influenced the evolution of social sciences as we see today. Now let us look into what changes occurred because of the above radical turn happened. We can look into the positive side first. We can see that commercial development was a great advantage of the radical turn which we have discussed previously. A lot of commerce and trade has improved. Second, development of transport and communication was another important positive side of such kind of a radical turn that we have discussed earlier. Then comforts of human being has increased, multiplication of human comforts. Then the system of education, enrollment of education has increased, methods of education has increased, and then health conditions of the people have increased, and then development of economic conditions of the people have increased. All these were the positive sides of the radical turn which we have seen earlier. Now let us look into the negative side of it. There was development of complexity in social life. The human relationship and its warmth has got changed. Social relationship has got changed. And there happened political chaos and then political disturbance and autocracy and anarchism has got into many nations. Colonialization was another important change of this political chaos. And then social disorganization and unrest from several parts of the country was another important negative side of this radical turn. Intellectual crisis was yet another one. It happened in such a way that the ruling party wanted to promote the intellectual thoughts of a particular section of people. And then another kind of people were faced difficulty. Say for example, British colonial rule in India. They promoted only the intellectual thoughts of the colonial British power in India. Indian nationals were not being considered as major intellectuals during the colonial power. Then development of unhealthy competition among people was another important negative side of the radical turn which we have seen. In order to counter all these problems and challenges, social sciences originated and became the part of education learning system. We have seen several important issues, for example, political chaos, for example, the crisis in the human relationship, intellectual crisis. All these issues were effectively addressed by the social sciences. Say for example, the economic difficulties faced by, economic crisis faced by various countries and various social systems were well addressed by the economics as a subject. So in that way, the evolution of modern economics is the result of the resultant difficulties that we have come across our society, that we have faced in our history. Social sciences thus originated in the 18th century in an effort to understand the character and future of modern society. So that's a very comprehensive conclusion which was made by Rawls in 1991 about the social sciences origin. He proposed that our modern social science is an attempt to predict or to understand the character of the future modern society. Social scientist has envisioned that social sciences that would guide modern society into the future by observing the difference between modern society and its feudal and ancient forms. So it's an invariable duty of the social sciences to keep on comparing the contemporary society, the future society and its past society or the ancient society. Due to the fast changes, many new social problems are arising and affecting the whole social system and paralyzing it. While the rapid growth of industrialization and modernization brings into multitude social problems, including diseases, social alienation, workers' exploitation, etc., modern science creates germ warfare, atoms for destruction of humanity, many hazardous chemical and nuclear reaction, etc. The misuse of science, urbanization, industrialization, etc. has resulted in two world wars, World War I and World War II, within a single century, that is 20th century. Severe economic depression from 1930 to 1940 created the feeling of insecurity, fear, suspicion, and distrust among the people of the world. Mainly this Great Depression was hit on America, but even still, this has created a global repercussion. The rapid growth of science and technology in the last 100 years has created many new social problems, even though it has many positive effects also. The social sciences emerged to prevent and check the evil effect of science, industrialization and modernization, and any other social issues that we come across today. Also, social science looks into the modern society for better future on the other hand. Social science also, the general sciences have proved that is capable of organizing the forces of the atom to cause the destruction of the entire humanity from the world by a single explosion. There is a need for studying social sciences to obstruct destruction of human society by such forces, and basically obstructing any kind of the evils of science and the allure of the human being for the power has become the duty of social sciences. Conception of social sciences. Let us go through few definitions of social sciences to understand its concept. According to Charles Baird, social sciences are body of knowledge and thought pertaining to human affairs. So, human affairs cannot be defined in a particular single terminology. Any kind of relationship between human society or among human society are part of human affairs. So, human being interact in a society with in a manifold means like economic, political, social and many other ways. So, all these kinds of interactions of human being are part of human affairs. So, hence any kind of an action of an individual in a society, his relationship with his social members are of course part of social science knowledge. Social sciences are those bodies of learning and study which recognize the simultaneous and mutual action of physical and non-physical stimuli which produce a social reaction. So, in nutshell, we can say that any kind of social action or any kind of action, physical, which can be physical or non-physical, which result in a social reaction. For example, tsunami which happened, which hit on India or which hit on many parts of the world, has been a social or has been an environmental reaction, but its reaction upon society was so great and its reaction upon the society was so hazardous, and then of course tsunami will become part of a social scientist's perception. And of course, then tsunami will become a part of social science concern, social scientist's concern. So, hence, any kind of natural phenomenon which has a social reaction or which has a social implication will become part of social sciences. The following points which I am going to discuss now characterize the nature of social science. First one is a direct bearing on human activity. For example, social sciences are those aspects of knowledge which have direct bearing on man's activity in different socio-cultural fields. Social sciences, again, second point which I am going to discuss is the advanced studies of human society. Social sciences are advanced level studies of human society, and they are generally taught at higher education level. Third important characteristic of social science is that to find out truths about human relationships. Social sciences seek to find out truths about human relationships which ultimately contribute to the social utility and advancement of knowledge. With this, I conclude our discussion about evolution of social sciences and conception of social science. Thank you.